going to the Broadway. My Lord, it's been a humble thing. I just thank the Lord again for this opportunity to speak on it. And I'm thankful for my wife, and she actually helped me when I was home. I had about 10 pages of material. Because it's been so much I've gotten from as I look back over it and read the scripture. So I cut it down to three. We get three things we're going to talk about. And I don't really have a theme scripture, but there's going to be three passages I talk about. And the first thing, we've already covered it. The first one is, he must be a husband first. And the key to it is that when God did, we're going to use the reference Mark 10, 5 through 9. We reference Genesis 2, 21 through 24, which is when God made Eve for Adam.
All right.
And he put them together.
Yeah.
But this was done before they had children. And that's where we set the framework for it. God set the framework for it. And that marriage comes first.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so in order to be a father, the guy should be a husband.
Yeah, that's right.
You know, because God set up the family structure for a reason, because of the stability that it provides.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
And you know, right now in the world today, it has been eroding the family structure for a while.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and now it's a big thing, and it started a while back because, you know, me and my wife have talked about it for a long time. And that, you know, they always want the young ladies to be chaste and pure, but they want the young men to get their clothes to go sow their oats.
Yeah.
It doesn't match up.
That's right.
Yeah.
It doesn't match up, because how can you have young ladies trying to be pure, but the young men can do whatever they want to do?
Mm-hmm.
You know, but going back to it, and you know, the world today, it is going to a structure now. It went from the family structure, then it went to the single parent home. And I was even getting to the point to where I saw someone on Facebook to where it's two people of the same gender raised people. And that's not a good
idea.
He meant for it to be children will be raised by a man and a woman.
Yeah.
And you know, and I'm speaking this, I know from my personal thing, I have my children without being married. And I know from experience that it causes problems. I don't care how good you are. But because you're not in the framework that God intended for, it's going to cause problems.
This is not a good book.
Okay.
So that's the first thing you have to understand. Before you be a father, you're supposed to be a husband first.
That's right.
And that's what was represented by the family. Then the next thing, is that you must love your wife the way Christ loved the church.
Come on.
Because as the husband, you're the head of that household. You're the priest of that household. So you got to be willing to serve in the role of Christ.
Yeah.
You know, and that's the first thing. Before your children go to church, it's supposed to be done in your home. You're the primary teacher. You set the
example. That's right.
And the first thing you spoke that is loving your wife the way Christ loved the church means that Christ sacrificed everything for the church. So you got to be willing to step into that role for your wife as a man.
Amen.
No, because that provides security and stability for knowing their parents are unified and love each other.
Mm-hmm.
Your children should see you doing things for your wife. This is an example of them on how they should treat their future spouse, if they're male and females, how they should be treated in their own marriage. It gives them a chance to see a good relationship. Not what they see on TV, they hear the music and movies today. It needs to be done in your home. That should be the example of what a true, good, loving relationship is. What's the one in your home?
Yeah.
If your kids are getting examples from that from the TV, you're doing something wrong.
Mm-hmm.
You know, for one, the husband must be able to sacrifice everything for her. He should make her well-being a priority.
Amen.
And he should care for her as he cares for his body. And the one thing you know, if you've been an athlete, you understand what that is. You know when you get ready to prepare for an event, like we used to do the PT test in the morning. I already know I got to drink more water, I got to start working out, do more push-ups in order to do well on the test. So you want to have the same type of care for your wife as you do for your body.
Yeah.
You know when you should learn your spouse to the point where you know what to do for her if you see her down. You know, you're supposed to know your wife
That's
and you
right.
can take care of her and be proactive. You know, you're not supposed to just wait till something happens. You should already be prepared for it so things won't be as bad.
Mm-hmm.
And the next thing is, is that he must give instructions to his children. And the scriptures for this one is Ephesians 6, 1 through 4. And I know from experience, the first one is one for parents. And you can get stuck on that one, but you got to be beat off and out.
Come on.
It says, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, this is the first commandment with a promise. I tell you, me personally, that's what I was stuck on. They had to obey me no matter what.
You stopped
it
too.
I stopped
that
too.
Yeah.
You know, but if you read all the way down, how are you that you make a way that you may live on in the land? Fathers do not want the children and bring up the discipline and instruction of the Lord.
Come on.
You got to take that whole thing into context. You just can't take one out of two.
That's good.
I know personally, I was taking them out of context. I was abusing the scripture because it meant that they're supposed to obey me if I'm bringing. They're supposed to obey me, true enough, but I'm supposed to bring them up in this destruction of the Lord. You know, I was doing a loving, caring way. I should not be walking in my hand.
Amen.
And I didn't let you know that was one of the problems I had.
That's all right. That's all right. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Okay. Use it up.
You're supposed to.
All right.
You are supposed to respect your children the same way that you want them to respect you.
Mm-hmm.
You're supposed to give them rules to obey and expect them to comply. And I know one of the things they say is that, you know, they say you're not going to bring your job home, but I guess, in a way, being in harmony, that's what I did. And, you know, I was actually.
That's all right. That's all right. That's all right. Thank you.
You helped
me sometimes. That's right. Thank you.
You know, I was treating my kids like they were soldiers.
Yeah.
That's what's wrong.
Yeah.
You know, because having a child is really, and raising a child is really one of the greatest things, the greatest job that God can ever give.
Amen.
It's all right. It's all right. There were some more soldiers too, so that's right. You weren't always soldiers.
No.
Thank God for the word. Hey, see you.
Thank God.
Yes, God. Yeah.
Children actually want rules and they want to obey.
Yeah.
But you have to make sure you do it in a way that brings honor to God,
yeah,
in a way that it doesn't provoke your children and stuff. If you think about it, if you were on your job,
yeah,
how offended you would be if the rules of the job changed every day.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you wouldn't have no direction, you wouldn't know where to. You wouldn't know how to do anything. You would be walking on pins and needles because you don't know what's that your thoughts are.
That's right.
And we sometimes have tendency to do that with our children, and it's not how we should do.
Amen. Amen. You'll help somebody.
You have to talk with your children.
That's right.
And I talk with them. Don't talk at them.
Yeah.
I don't talk with them.
Yeah.
You know, and we didn't attest to this. I think when Richard Jr. was in hospital, I think every day for about a good 6 months, we would have an argument every single day about him not wearing a belt. I mean, we'd be toe-to-toe screaming at you in each other's face. And I think I was wrong with that because I should have backed off of that.
Mm-hmm.
I kept wanting him to do it, but it became to me to where, you know, and I hate to say it, and it may be wrong, I actually look forward to that, and it's crazy. You know, I'm a shoulder who is a boss. But I'm looking like a raving idiot every day I come down screaming toe-to-toe in his face about putting on a zip. At certain ages, children want to share everything with you. During these times, you just need to do a good listen. You don't need to step in and try to solve every problem, which I know I had a tendency to do.
Yeah.
You know, because they're not going to learn how to handle situations on their own. If
that's
you right. Each and every
that's
time.
Good. That's good. That's good.
If you listen to them, this will help them know that you care about them and things going on in their life. When the time comes that they're less likely to share with you, they will remember that you took the time to listen when their conversation prepared and immature. And let's see that now, me and my sons can talk, and it's getting to the point where Sonya and I can talk about this.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
As your children get older, they try to find interest in the things that they're interested in. This will give you comfort off conversation. There will be rough years when you feel like they're not talking to you as much as you would like. But make sure they have your attention. They have your attention when they hear you talk. It will open up opportunities in the future. And I'll be getting better at that. Instead of when they're talking to me playing on my phone or on the computer, I've actually been doing it now.
Amen.
You know, and that's something that I encourage everyone to do.
Amen.
If we go out and even having family dinners, I tell them, we don't put up the phone for this time. You know, we don't get back to the
community. Yeah. Yeah.
You better listen to people.
Yeah.
That's rude. Right. You know, if you really want to have a good relationship, you got to put down the phone, put down the technology and actually talk to each other.
Amen.
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 That's when you're supposed to take your children to church. Now, but it's got to be more than just taking them to church.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I'm speaking from experience.
Yeah.
If you're just coming to church, but you're not, you want them to take you in and live it out with them, but you're not doing it, it's not going to go.
Amen.
What your children are not going to get, because like I say, their first example is you.
That's right.
Yeah. Yeah.
Their first example is you. So, you want them to listen, obey, and do God's will, but you're not going to.
Amen.
We have to set the example.
Amen.
You know, I know they have, being a teacher, you know, they say they have so many different styles of learning than everybody does. But if you're going to live God's way, the only way you do it is by example.
That's right.
It's by the examples you see.
That's it. That's it.
Yeah.
And you have to realize each child is different. And that's the thing about being a son. You know, we have to keep cutting back on doing things. You do what the person in charge says. It's no way they don't ask your opinion, your interpretation. You just do what it says. But your children are not like that. You can't treat them all the same. You can have the same rules. Everything, your discipline structure can be the same, but you got to understand every child is different. So you have to sometimes enforce the rules differently. And it's not that you're being unfair, but every child is different. You have to accommodate for that.
That's right.
If one child is strong-willed, you don't need to try and mold them into you. Let them be who they're going to be. If you raise them up the way God wants them to be, they're going to grow up to be the person God wants them to be. It's not who you want them to be.
Yes,
Lord. That's good.
Now, you can talk with them about maybe they need to talk a little bit more, be more considerate of others. Those are the things you can help them with. But you're not trying to mold the next version of you.
Amen.
You know, you may find one child is going to find the most please everyone. You got to help them develop the system to the needs of others in a good way. Mm-hmm. You can't tell everybody yes.
Mm-hmm.
However, you also need to learn to stand up for yourselves and do what is right.
Yes.
And you just cannot expect the teaching you give to one child is going to work for every other child.
Right.
Treat each child as an individual you will raise, and you can raise goodly, godly children who honor the Lord. And the last one is, let your children be children.
Yes.
Your children are not there to be your babysitter. Mm-hmm. They're not there to be the one to take care of other children.
Yeah.
They're not there to take care of you.
Yeah.
They're not there to be your slave.
Yes.
Let your children be children.
Amen.
That's good.
And they will have good things to look back on. That's one of the ways that you're going to raise them up in their strong. God wants them to be children.
Amen.
That's a good time.
Yeah.
You don't have no worries. You know, because when you get grown, trust me, you're going to want to go back to being a child.
Yeah.
But you want your children to have good memories on being a child, one that you love and care for.
Right. Right.
You know, one of the ways you can frustrate your children is to have unrealistic expectations for them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we see it all the time, as I did with youth sports. people want to live through their children.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they didn't just be running back, so they want their son to be the running back.
Right.
Mm. Maybe your son doesn't want to play sports.
Come on, that's it. Yeah.
Maybe that's not the God to give God an ask for your child.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's nothing wrong with letting them experience it, but don't force it on them.
That's good. Yeah.
Just because you are a basketball player doesn't mean your sons are going to become one.
Amen.
You know, at some point in time, you have to realize they have a certain thing that God wants them to do.
That's right.
And it's not for us to try and put our will onto them.
That's right.
You're going to frustrate us. God's discipline is a loving discipline, has a higher good in mind. He instructs us through trials, suffering, and His word. So we as fathers got to understand our role, that we can make or break a child depending on how we treat them. So God commands us, not just suggest to us, to bring them up in the same type of discipline that He does.
That's right.
God deals with us in a fair, when God deals with us, He is not unjust, unfair, and over-demanding. So that means that we should not be that way to our children.
Amen.
Be patient, understanding, loving, and caring, and compassionate as God is to us, because then that's when they become what God intends for them to be. As we open up the doors of the church, I pray that someone got something out of the message, you know, and really understand that right now, the role of being